This is a disclaimer. I do not condone the illegal use of stealing phones or others' data. These videos are used for educational purposes and to get the companies to notice the vulnerabilities in their product. Thank you.
Hello, YouTube. Today I'm going to do a factory reset on the Samsung A10E variant. This is the fastest and easiest method to getting back into your phone. As I've said before, if your phone in your hands doesn't look like the one on screen, then you're on the wrong video. If it does, you're in luck. You may factory reset your phone for a number of reasons. Social media is eating away at your brain? The government is tracking you and you live off the grid? Well, for this phone, I have the solution. But, before we get started, if this video ends up helping you or a forgetful family member, leave a like or a comment or a share or anything to help your friends out too. Now that that's out of the way, I set up a Gmail account and a Samsung account and created a pattern lock. This is all to act as if the device was in full lockdown for the purpose of breaking the factory reset protection lock, otherwise known as the FRP lock. To start this video out, you're going to need a PC running either Windows 7, 8, 8.1, or Windows 10, or even 11. If that's not a problem, the second part would be to download this application for your Windows computer. I'll provide the link in the description. After downloading the app onto your PC, just plug in a USB from your PC to your phone. Hop onto your phone and power it on. Wait until it reaches the lock screen, then leave the phone be right where it's at on the lock screen. What you're going to want to do now is look to your PC and open the software that I provided in the description below. Look to the section labeled Test Mode. Right under the purple logo, you should see a drop-down bar and two buttons labeled Info and Reboot to the right of the drop-down button. If you don't see the name of your device, turn it off and on and take out the USB and plug it back in. You'll be looking for the drop-down bar to display the name of your device right alongside the Info and Reboot buttons. If you see your device's name, press the Info button to the right of the drop-down. It may not work the first time and say the COM port failed in red. If so, just retry the button and all your info should appear. Pressing the button is basically just to ensure the next step will work. The next part is fairly simple. Do not remove the USB until otherwise, though. Now, you're going to want to put your phone into recovery mode. To do this, you'll want to power off the device first. Before you power it back on, you'll want to hold the volume up button and the power button down while turning the device back on. The phone wouldn't let me power it off without putting in the pattern. In order to circumvent this, I held both the power button and held down the volume button for about 7 seconds to power off the phone. In this mode, you can only use the volume up and down buttons to move the highlighted subject. The power button will act like a select button here. You'll want to highlight the factory reset option and select it with the power button. Choose yes, you are sure, and let the device wipe. Your phone should react immediately. Do not touch anything. The phone will do all the work on its own from here. Thank you. After it's done resetting the data, you're going to want to reboot the phone, of course. The loading here will take a while, so pitch a tent and get comfortable. Once the device is completely reset, it gets quite simple from here. After resetting the phone, I took the time to look at the info of it just to make sure that the phone would still work as intended while doing this. From this point, you'll want to press the emergency call button on your phone. You should see the option on the Let's Go screen on the start of the phone when it powers back on. In the emergency call button, you'll want to type these numbers out. I've also put the numbers in the description so that you can follow them more easily. This will bring up a test panel on your phone. From this point, leave your phone alone and turn your attention to your PC. For my own sake, I disabled the factory mode in order to break the logic of the FRP lock more. As long as you follow the proper instructions, you should get a prompt saying that your computer is trying to connect through USB debugging. Accept this, and from here your phone will do its magic. There's no need to press any buttons or touch anything. It may take a few minutes to load, and then load some more after. It should bring you straight back into the phone if done properly though. It seems it didn't go properly or the way it was supposed to for me this time, but that's okay. We could still fix this. I made a mistake off screen and accidentally clicked the wrong button, but not to waste your time, I made an edit out of the video for it. Knox is the security system that Samsung has been using since the Samsung S3 to protect devices from factory reset. Breaking this should cause it to crash, just like every other time. You'll have to go all the way back to the starting screen that says, "Let's go." Tap the emergency button and type these numbers, the same ones in the description below. Once again, you'll pull up the secret phone panel. From here, you'll want to allow the prompt for USB debugging and disable Knox. Again, let the phone do its magic and do not touch anything. The phone started to break the lock screen off screen, but I caught it as it was doing it. Since the phone will just force you in, from here you could either continue to use the phone as is, or factory reset the phone again to have a clean new start. As you can see from my end though, both the Samsung account and the Google account that were originally on this device are now completely wiped off. Remember, if this video helped you in any way, please leave a like, comment, or share to help me grow my audience. Thank you.
Techspansion.